The maintainers across the Air Force are a passionate crowd. What motivates them most is watching the weapon system they take care of fly.
Our U.S. Air Force has spent the last 25 plus years engaged in combat every day. The question now is, how much longer will we be in this? And I think the answer is for another half a generation or another generation.
We are not the most powerful Air Force in the world because of the weapon systems we have. We are the most powerful Air Force in the world because of the people we have.
There are a lot of challenges that face the sustainment of these weapon systems out there, and the solutions are going to come from the collective of the entire Air Force. It's going to have to come from every single one of us being able to contribute to facing the challenges that we've got ahead of us and maybe bring some new idea to how we can handle this job that we do a little bit differently than we have in the past.
Just about everything now involves software. The Pentagon historically has been terrible at buying software. So the Air Force decided to change the game.
What we learned was that we actually need to build a software company inside of the Air Force that can sense and respond to conflict in any domain, anytime, anywhere.
The Air Force Lifecycle Management Center opened a detachment in downtown Boston named Kessel Run. Kessel Run has started a revolution in the way the Air Force acquires and fields software. These airmen take off their uniforms, team up with civilians, and develop software our warfighters need and love.
So what we're doing here at Kessel Run is making sure that we have really short feedback loops directly with our users, so we can always ensure that we're building the right thing and providing value from day one. So with the way that we do modern software development, utilizing continuous delivery, we were able to build what we call a minimum viable product. What is the first piece of value that we can provide to our warfighters as fast as possible, and then constantly learn from it and grow off that?
Our maintainers are fighting today's wars with old and outdated processes. They're building maintenance schedules on Excel spreadsheets and tracking personnel on whiteboards. Kessel Run is developing a suite of applications named Torque that can integrate all of their procedures in one easy-to-use place. Torque is a series of fully integrated web-based applications that help make maintainers' day-to-day job easier and faster. Their workload breaks down into essentially three domains: planning the work, managing the plan, and execution.
Planning the work portion is mostly about making sure that you have the right people, the right equipment available at the right place and right time. So we broke that down into knowing that you have the aircraft assigned to the right unit, you have your personnel scheduled to the shifts that they need based on their certs and qualifications, and also that you can build out a weekly schedule optimizing the requirements from ops and maintenance.
The problem is no plan survives contact with the real world, but Torque gives airmen the flexibility they need to adapt.
So the beauty of Torque is the time savings from being able to document the work at the point that it's being done. We want to make sure that since things are always changing in maintenance, we give them all the data that they need to be able to make those right decisions. So as a status of an aircraft changes, or a part's coming in that wasn't supposed to come in, they can take that information in and then recreate the plan given that new information they have.
It's going to help you maintain your aircraft, you know, from the cradle to the grave, basically. Investing in technology like this is important for the Air Force because, I mean, times are changing, and the people that we're enlisting or people that are commissioning are more technology-based. So it's highly important for us to keep moving forward with the times and, you know, stay relevant, basically. Things that we did in the 50s or in the 60s are not relevant to the things that we're doing in 2020.
Kessel Run's goal was to increase aircraft availability, reduce cost per flying hour, and increase mobility through the use of modern technology and process revolutions. Now Torque's applications are in use across various missions and airframes.
The next conflict is not a conflict of attrition. It's a conflict of cognition. It won't be tanks, planes, and ships that are the central differentiator in tomorrow's conflict. That conflict's going to be data-centric. And it will be software on every device, in every domain, that will determine the course of it. This is a strategic imperative.